Yeah, thanks very much for inviting me to tell how we at Klöckner want to transform the steel and metals industry. I had prepared some slides, but I decided to skip that and tell you a bit of our story and how you might help us or support us going forward. So we from Klöckner, we are not as old as the other two companies we just had, so we are only more than 100 years old. But we are, of course, also in a very old-fashioned industry, in the steel industry. We are not a steel producer, we are a steel distribution company or steel service center company. That means we're buying steel from the big producers and selling steel to all kinds of customers. Our sales are about 6.5 billion, and we have about 200 sites. 60% of our business is in Europe, 40% in North America. The steel industry itself is under severe pressure since a couple of years because of this huge overcapacities, especially from China. This is one issue where we're also suffering from. And then on the other side, also the steel supply chain, the so far still linear pipeline-driven steel supply chain is very old-fashioned. So we practically have here no effective data because there is no seamless information flow. We have no effective data on supply and demand. And with this, deliveries are often late, deliveries are often wrong or are not coming at all. And as a consequence, there is a lot of steel being stocked throughout the value chain. And a certain part of our initial core business, steel stock holding, depends on this intransparency, because we had to stock steel to provide to our customers, especially in the spot business, to provide the steel they want to get. But when there would be a platform which would move away this intransparency, then also a significant part of our core business would be moved away. And against this background, we were developing a couple of years ago, 4 years ago, meanwhile, the vision of an industry platform, of a digital industry platform where all participants within this industry are connected. So on the one side, the producers, on the other side, the customers, but also, of course, our competitors and then a couple of third-party groups and companies. That was our vision. We started to develop this platform not in a conventional way, how we typically do it as an incumbent, that we setting up a big project team, that we're spending a lot of money. We started very small. We started with two people here in Berlin in the Beta House in a co-working space, and we started to find out from the customers where their pain points really are. We developed then the first prototypes, the first minimal viable products. We implemented these products. We then improved these products or tools together with our customers. And we're doing this here in Berlin in our own startup, if you like, called Klöckner.ai. We meanwhile employing here 50 people out of mostly digital natives. And with this 50 people, we're developing all these tools and finally the platform. This is, of course, a different company than Klöckner. We have different resources. We have, on the one side, we have assets and steel guys. On the other side, we have digital natives and intellectual properties. On the one side, we have we're going always for perfection, and we have reliable processes. On the other side, we have the lean startup approach. We have agile software development and others. So very different companies and with very different cultures. A very important issue here is when you, as an incumbent, establish such a digital hub or a startup, the very important issue is how to position this company. How independent should such a setup be? When it's too independent, then you don't leveraging the assets you have as an incumbent. As an incumbent like we have the assets of the steel know-how, we have a lot of customers, thousands of customers, and we have all the suppliers, so we have access to them. So, and when the startup or when this digital hub is too far away, then it's difficult to leverage these assets. On the other side, when it's too close, then it gets too much impacted from the corporate. I think, meanwhile, we found here the right position, so we are far enough away from Klöckner to leverage all these assets, and we are close enough we are close enough to leverage all these assets, but far enough to get not impacted too much by the corporate. The development of this platform is, of course, a huge effort. We are what we internally are saying and at step two. So we have, meanwhile, what we're calling a service platform. This is still a proprietary platform, but we're now starting to open this platform also for third party parties, and then finally also for competitors. Going forward, we now have again a team here in Berlin who is developing with us all the necessary features of this platform. We're working here together with a company from New York, and we are in about 2 months. We can then really start to the final steps to implement to implement this new platform. What can you do? How can you help us? So we don't want to develop this platform only on our own. We want to develop this platform with partners. We are here open for partners. So when you are a startup and when you think that you can provide something for this kind of platform, then we are interested to work together with you. We might be also interested in investors because we think that finally that we finally have to move this platform somewhat away from Klöckner, maybe even a white label platform finally, and this could also be interesting for investors who want to invest in B2B business. We bring a lot to this kind of investments because of our know-how, what we have, and this is really necessary when you want to transform industry like steel. You need a lot of internal know-how. I, for instance, was visiting in the last 2 weeks all of our German subsidiaries, and I had discussions with all our salespeople, and we had about 130 points which we have to take in care of to make sure that selling steel online, that this really works. This is much more difficult than you think. It's not like we're selling no standard products. We're selling no products which have a specific price. So we are a vertical platform. We're selling also services like 3D laser cutting and so on. We are not a horizontal platform. We are selling not only standard products with standard prices. And for these vertical platforms, there is a lot of this know-how necessary, but we also need the know-how from startups to make this happen much more quicker than we are used to it in the past. And this is something which could attract some of you. Yeah, to sum it up, we think that we are here with our platform strategy on the right way. We think that we're moving here clearly in the right direction. We will see this kind of platforms also in other industries. We will see here also some kind of winner-takes-it-all effect. Maybe there's not finally one platform. Maybe there are finally two or three platforms, but not that many. But important is that you start as early as possible. And when you want to support something to this, please get in contact with me, and we may then do something together. Thanks very much for having me. Thank you.